Everyone knows Sega loves the Sonic franchise with great games such as Sonic 06, Sonic Free Riders, and Sonic and the Black Knight. So I was pretty excited when the Sonic Generations demo hit Xbox Live Marketplace and PlayStation Network a few days ago. And as soon as it hit, I knew it had to be good. After all, Sonic 06 sold so well that it was even a Platinum Family hit on the bargain bin on the Xbox 360. Seriously. When you first load the game, you will get a message that tells you that the game can only be played for 20 days. Either it's really good, or it's really terrible. You then get logos from Sega, and a message that this game uses Havok physics and is made by Sonic Team. Afterwards, the game can continue. But first off, you have to sign into Xbox Live. You have to sign into Xbox Live or PlayStation Network to play the game. After starting the game, you can be wowed by environments that look so good that they blend in with the background. Same with the enemies. Remember the Sonic games where you can actually see the enemies? In this game, it's hard to see the enemies you're attacking, so it's pretty awesome because of that. The controls are pretty great too. Remember back when Sonic games actually had controls that were decent and moved? Well, in this game, the controls lag, so you can get caught in the spikes a lot. It's pretty fun and pretty awesome too. After all, everyone loves getting caught in the spikes. Don't you love getting caught in the spikes? The gameplay isn't anything like classic Sonic either. Instead, you run through giant corridors like in newer Sonic games. You blast through X buff points, and best of all, well, the controller's still lagging. All in all, Sonic Generations is one of the best games of this generation, featuring bad controls, laggy gameplay, graphics that blend in with the backgrounds, and best of all, it's probably going to cost $40 to $50, only on the PS3, 3DS, and 360. Don't buy it, or wait till it goes in the bargain bin. It's that good.